All right, so obviously the Oscar nominations are out, and the one thing that gets people going is, A, what are people going to wear? Which is probably important for some, but for me, it's who am I going to bet on? This is the pool I want to be in. I'm worried about being in a death pool for all the bad karma, but an Oscar pool I have no problem being in. So let's go to a guy who would know for 7 years. You saw him on The Daily Show as a movie critic. Now he's got himself some fine talk show on Sirius Satellite Radio. He's in New York City. Frank Licaro joins us. Hello, sir. How are you?
Hey, George, how are you? It's great to be on your show.
No, it's good to have you here. So this is a big day, man. The Oscar nominations are out, and movies that are often talked about and few people see get celebrated with nominations.
It's a huge day. It is. This year, more than most, though, I think it really is a collection of things that even I don't want to go see. Because other than Dreamgirls, I'm sitting around now that I've seen that, and I'm going to wait for Spider-Man 3. So that's kind of it for me.
Now does that speak to how the Academy perhaps out of touch with what the people want? Or is it more importantly that the Oscars are about craft in a way that the mainstream films perhaps aren't?
I think they're a snotty group of old people, and all they care about are movies we don't want to see. I really do think that's all they're really about. And when you look at the nominees, I think my theory is borne out.
we'll go through the nominees in just a second. How do you get the votes for this, by the way? I mean, you always see the ads for your consideration. There was that funny mockumentary that came out about that as well. Like, how do you get votes for your picture?
I think you sort of have to hype yourself as best you possibly can and make it seem like they have to vote for you, that it's so much more than just voting for a movie, that you're voting for God and country or the fate of independent cinema, or it's something larger than you're going to give a nice trophy to someone wearing a borrowed gown.
Exactly. All right, let's go through some of the nominations. I want to start with Best Actress. I just had flown in from the Sundance Festival, and I saw The Queen on the plane, and Helen Mirren was awesome in this one. But let's start with the Best Actress category. You got, you know, Penelope, Judy, Helen, Meryl, Kate. What do you think about that category?
I think it's going to come down to either Helen Mirren for The Queen, or it's going to be Meryl Streep for The Devil Wears Prada. I think basically if you go with one of those two in the pool, you'll do pretty well. I think even though Meryl is brilliant in Prada, my money's going to be on Helen Mirren. Because I think it's her year this year. I mean, she's played more queens than I have, and she's done really well by it.
How many queens have you played, man?
No, just me. No, just one.
All right, let's go. Helen was great. I think Penelope Cruz was strong in Volvere as well. I mean, I don't know if they're going to go that road.
I don't know if they'll give it to her, but Penelope Cruz, I don't like her in English, to be honest. But in Spanish, my God, she's beautiful in Spanish. I don't know what that's about. I have no interest in her in English. But you put her in a Pedro Almodovar movie, and I am so there. That was, I think, one of the few films that I actually was running to see. She was brilliant in that.
Dude, I'd be into Penelope if she spoke Klingon, okay? I'd be fine with that. All right, from Best Actor to Best Performance by an Actor in a Leading Role. What do you think about that category and some of the names in there?
Well, I thought it was interesting because Leonardo DiCaprio is not up for The Departed. He's up for Blood Diamond, which was really another not-so-feel-good movie. You know, like, you can't eat veal and you can't wear fur, and now apparently you can't wear diamonds either, so there's no fun at all. I was a little upset with him, though, because he recently was talking about how he's not some cute piece of meat, is what he said. And I don't know, I just saw his nude photographs on one of the blogs, and you know what? He is a cute little piece of meat. I like him a lot. But I don't know if he's going to get it. Ryan Gosling is up for Half Nelson, which none of us have seen. And if it was like Half Nelson Reilly and he was playing Charles Nelson Reilly, I would have liked it better. Forrest Whitaker, I think, is going to take it.
Yeah,
I really do think, we've been calling that movie The Last King of Scotland. We've been calling it the last movie I'd ever see, but because it really is. I'm not going to go. But I think Forrest Whitaker's going to walk home with it.
I think you're absolutely right about that. Ryan Gosling, great in Half Nelson. The soundtrack from a really cool band called Broken Social Scene. What's neat about the Best Actor, though, you have a DiCaprio, you know, a Will Smith, Forrest Whitaker, Peter O'Toole. So this is clearly not an ageist. This is a very diverse lineup of men.
Well, definitely. Yeah. Well, Peter O'Toole, but do you really want to see him get up? I mean, we love Peter O'Toole, but he's kind of, you know, an unattractive old man right now. I don't want to see him on the show. I want to see Beyonce. It's basically, I just want Beyonce to get up there, even though I don't think she's nominated for anything. Yeah, maybe a song she's up for. I don't know.
I think she is a song. I'm looking at the Best Actor thing. She's definitely not in that one. A director. Here's what's neat about the director one. You got the guy who made Babel, obviously Scorsese, Eastwood, Frears for The Queen, and Paul Greengrass. Now, when United 93 was mentioned, there was quite a reaction, wasn't there?
I think we were all shocked that Paul Greengrass was nominated there for United 93. But talk about a movie you didn't want to go see. Oh, my God. That was number one on my list. And as one of my colleagues on Sirius said, if that plane is not being flown by Karen Black, I'm not going. And that's the way we felt about it. If it wasn't going to be that kind of movie, we weren't going to see it.
I figured the biggest problem with United 93 was that everybody knew how it was going to end. What's going to be the best picture this year?
For Best Picture, I'm wondering who they're going to give it to. I'm assuming, since the Golden Globe went to Babel, that they're going to give it to Babel. I don't think they'll give it to Little Miss Sunshine, even though I think it's great that it was nominated. The Queen, I think it's good, but it's an American group. I don't think they're going to really honor that. The Departed, maybe. It would be interesting to see if that happened. But it could go to Letters from Iwo Jima, and we'll see. The Academy loves Clint Eastwood, and so it could be, voting for God and Country, as I said.
They certainly could. Scorsese is nominated for Best Director. Now, it would be ironic if he finally won his Academy Award for a film that wasn't really his idea, that they just remade for a North American audience. But do you think this could be Scorsese's year?
Oh, I hope so. Martin Scorsese, he's sort of like the Susan Lucci of the Oscars, the poor thing. I hope they give it to him. I mean, he's had a lot of party dresses that just didn't get worn. You know, I feel bad for him. I hope that they finally do honor him. And this year certainly seems as good as any to give it to him. And
one punch-up. Is there going to be a good backstage thing that we can look forward to? Is there something building?
Well, I hope that they give it to Jennifer Hudson, because I don't know about you, but if I were her and I didn't get the Oscar, I think I would I'd eat my way through that entire backstage. I really would. I would eat the other nominees, and I think she just might do that.
Well, we'll find out, and if she does, we'll come back to you. Hey, Frank, thanks for your time, man. We appreciate it.
It was my pleasure. Thanks for having me on.
Frank DeCaro right there. It was obviously a big day for Canadians as far as the Oscar goes. He had mentioned Ryan Gosling nominated. There were other ones. So take a look.